Hello there, it's Carrie Rhodes here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I am sharing the Whimsical and Wild stamp sets created by Jane Davenport for Spellbinders. Jane Davenport is known for her mixed media, so today I am breaking out my gel press and making some prints to use in today's card. And specifically, I'm going to be doing some finger painting. So let's get started. Here is my gel press. You can see it is well loved, and so are my paints. They're getting quite low, so I decided I would make the best of it, get the most out of it that I could. So I cut the top off and scooped out that little remaining paint from inside that tube, and I'm just spreading it onto my gel press with my palette knife. So I have some black paint, some white paint, and also some gray. So this is the background I want to make for my elephant card. So I'm just smearing that around, and I know it's a ton of paint on my gel press, so I decided to bring in my second gel press. That way, when I have all this paint on my finger, I can transfer it over to the other one. So I got the idea for finger painting on my gel press from a video that I watched from the gel press channel. So I'll leave a link to that below. And it's just like going back to kindergarten. I really had so much fun doing this and getting a little bit messy. And I just wanted a print that had tones and shades of gray. So that's why I brought in the black and the white to mix in with my gray, so it'd have more interest. And you can see I've transferred paint over onto my second gel press so I can get lots of prints. So I'm gonna take my first print here, and because I had so much paint on there, I'm actually gonna be able to get two prints right away. So you can see how much paint's left there. But look at this print with the texture and the just the swirls from the finger painting. I love it. So now with that wet paint still on there, I can pick up a second print, which is actually called a ghost print. And even though it's the same exact plate and I haven't changed anything, the print is very different than the first one. Now I'm going to let the paint dry on both of these plates. And when that paint dries, we're able to go back in and put a layer of paint on there to reactivate the paint and pick it up and get an amazing print. I like to use white paint for this. It's a technique I learned in a class I took from Carolyn Dubay, and she calls this technique let it ride, so I call it that too. So you're just putting a light layer of a heavy bodied white paint on there, lay your cardstock on top, and let it dry for about 5 minutes. I like to just go away, clean up my tools, and come back to it in a few minutes. And then we're gonna get some amazing prints here. So through the magic of television, we don't have to wait 5 minutes. We can see it right now. So here's the first one. And by the way, these are a little hard to peel off. You do have to use your muscles a little bit. So hey, no going to the gym if you're doing these techniques. So there is our first print, and you can see how cool that looks. The second one I was really excited about. This is the plate that I transferred my finger over to. And here my paper ripped a little bit, and that's because I had like a clump of paint that didn't dry and the rest of the paint was dry. So it just kind of stuck there and peeled back my paper. But I love this one, and it's the print I end up using for my card. So let's take a look at the three prints I was deciding between. I actually don't show the very first print right here. I'm not sure why, but I love how these turned out. They're gonna be great for card making and paper piecing. So here I'm gonna stamp my elephant right on this little section, and I'm using VersaFine Onyx black ink. It's a really thick ink, and it will sit nicely on top of this acrylic paint. So I'll press that into place, and then I'm gonna set that aside so it can really dry. And I'll stamp a second elephant on a piece of whipped cream cardstock. This one I'm going to be doing some paper piecing as well as some coloring with my Journey Color Burst pencils. These are also sold at the Spellbinder shop. I love how it has this color palette up top, and it shows you how you can mix some of the colors to make new colors. So I'm going to color this out in layers. When I'm coloring with colored pencils, I like to come in with a really light hand and build up the layers, whether I'm using one pencil or two or more. So here I'm just adding some shading, and then you'll see me go back and forth between my lightest pink and my darker pink just to smooth out those pencil lines. If you come in with a heavy hand immediately with your colored pencils, you're actually going to be filling in the tooth of that paper and you won't be able to blend it out anymore. So with colored pencils, the golden rule is light layers. So now I'm going to be coloring in her skin, and I have three different colors I'm using here. I kind of like the white just to smooth things out and have it not be so harsh for skin. I just want it to look, you know, natural. So that's what I'm going for here. And then after I get that done, I'll color in her shirt. I'm only using one colored pencil here, but I am adding some shading there because I'm coloring in those light layers. Now to soften everything out, I have a blending stump, but I did not use any Gamsol with this today. Just the blending stump. I added a little shading on the tusks and then I'll cut this out. I wanted to cut right outside of the black line and realized it was better if I left a tiny bit of a white border here. So I'll finish cutting that out and then we're going to bring in the elephant that I stamped on my gel press print and cut that out as well. This time I want to cut right on the black line because I am going to be paper piecing, so sticking this one on top of the one stamped on white. So I don't need the tusks, I'll remove that. I don't need the girl, I'll cut that away, and I'll cut in where her elbows are resting on the elephant, so this looks like one seamless piece. But I cannot tell you how much I love this print for the elephant. It is so cool, so much interest. Now see here, my trunks don't exactly line up. That means that when I laid the stamp down, being that it's a clear stamp, it can move a little bit. So I'm just going to cut off the one on the white side, and then I don't have to worry about that not lining up exactly. So we'll glue these two together, and using liquid glue gives me the advantage of being able to scoot that around and get it lined up exactly how I want it and perfectly in place. See, right around her elbows there, and moving that so the tusks line up there at the bottom. Thank you so much, liquid glue. I love liquid glue. It's like my favorite. Then we can trim off the excess from the back so it lines up with the white one, and this is going to fit perfectly in the corner of my card. So moving on to the next step, I wanted to have a little feather for my elephant to hold. I thought that was the cutest extra image in the stamp set. I tried black, I didn't love it, so I brought out a gray paint, and that was perfect for him to hold in his little trunk. For the background on this card, I'm bringing in another Jane Davenport product, the Four Feathers die set. I cut them out from white and I'm going to glue them onto this white panel. I like the tone on tone that kind of makes it look like it's dry embossed. And then I'm using the elephant so that I can figure out how I want to place these feathers. And once I have that all figured out, I'm going to glue them down. I'm going to bring in my Tombow Aqua liquid glue and mix that with a tiny bit of water. I have an old paintbrush here, and I'm going to paint the glue onto the back of these feathers. Now this glue dries clear with a matte finish and is not tacky when it's dry. So it's perfect for this. If you get a little seep through, it's not gonna matter, and it rubs right off your fingers so easily. Kind of like rubber cement when we were little. It just rubbed off really easy. So now we're going to bring in a paper towel, because what if you got a little too much glue and you didn't want all those, you know, large globs there. So just bring in a dry paper towel and press that into place. I'll finish off the last two feathers and then I'll flip it over and cut off any overhang. And that is my feathered background. I thought it needed a little sparkle, so I'm bringing in some sparkle silk and splattering that on this background. All the products that I'm using today, I will list for you below in case you want to check that out. So they'll be right below in the description box for you. All right, let's add that elephant to the card with some liquid glue. And you see it fits perfectly in the corner. Love it. Next, we need to add in the little feather right in his trunk. I love how there's a little opening so he can hold it. So precious. A little throwback to Dumbo, right? Okay, for our sentiment, I'm going to stamp Dream Big on a pink piece of cardstock so it kind of matches our tutu. And I'm going to fussy cut around this so it looks like it's die cut. There is no die cut to match this, but I couldn't really stamp it right on the card because of that super textured background. So I just like to turn my cardstock in my left hand, holding my scissors still, and that helps me cut around this. Now, this is sped up greatly because I went slow and took my time. I put that onto the card front with some foam squares and then glued the entire thing to a top folding white note card. And now we're just going to add some bling with some sequins. So I'll glue those into place. And then I'm going to come back with some Journey Glaze and fill these with this clear glaze, and it just gives them some extra shine. And I also added this to the feather so it would stand out a little bit more. And that completes card number one. And I can't even tell you how much I love that elephant. So cool. Okay, card number two, we're taking the fingerprint painting up a notch. I have some brown paint here. I'm dipping my finger in and just painting some organic shapes onto this gel press. I'm wanting this to look like giraffe print. Now, giraffes are my favorite animal, so I felt like, oh, I really wanted this to turn out and be amazing. So I was a little bit excited and nervous about this one. After I get all the shapes painted, I'm going to let this dry. Then I'm going to come back and take that yellow golden paint and I'm going to brayer it right over the top, doing that let it ride technique this time with my colored paint. Now, this is all the paint that I have. This was also one that was running out. So I just brayered that over the top and hoped that it turned out, because this was the perfect giraffe color. So again, I'm gonna let that set for about 5 minutes, just doing some cleanup and other things while I'm waiting, but you can peek at the other side of your gel press to see what it might look like. All right, so I'm also gonna clean my brayer off on a piece of scratch, or actually it's a piece of cardstock, and I will use that print later. To the left there, you see another fingerprinting I did that I didn't end up using, but look at this giraffe paper. I was so excited about how it turned out. So we'll set that aside and bring back our stamps. And this time I'm using the giraffe set, of course, and I'm going to color that out with the same colored pencils. Light layers again. So I have this golden yellow color. I put a light layer in, then I'm going to bring in a brown colored pencil and color in some of his spots. And I'll just keep going back and forth between the two colors, adding layers and shading where I want it. Now on the brown spots, I decided I wanted it to look a little bit scratchy, not perfectly colored. So it would kind of go with my gel press print that is not like exactly perfect spots. So I like how it turned out. I think this giraffe is adorable. I also added another image from this set, the little flower. I'll color that with pink and we'll use that on the finished card as well. So I cut those things out, and then I also die cut a circle from that paper where I cleaned my brayer off, and that's going to be what I stamp my sentiment on. It says, "Reach for the sky." So we'll stamp that with some brown ink so it really ties in with the colors on our card, and I did end up stamping that about 3 times to really intensify that color. I'm bringing in a die set called My Sunshine and die cutting those pieces to mount this sentiment on, so it is a little sunshine in the sky. They layer up really well, and it just adds that little bit of dimension around the circle, and then those rays of sun are so cute. This is burlap paper that I'm gluing on. I got this a while back from Spellbinders when they had one of their big blowout clearance sales, which, by the way, is happening right now. I'll put a link to the Spellbinder shop in the comments below so you can check that out, because they do it once a year, and wow, they have things for like a dollar. So you want to check it out. So I'm attaching all the things to my card, some with dimension and some I'm gluing straight to the card base. We'll also bring in some bling for this card in just a moment. But first, I really wanted to use that sentiment that is giraffe wisdom. Stay above the drama, stretch yourself, stick out your neck. It's just a really cute sentiment for the inside of this card. All right, so I added some Wink of Stella shimmer around the edge of the sun, and then that Journey glaze, I spread a thin layer out right over that sentiment to add some shine. And then I decided to use the Journey glaze to add my sequins and then also fill them in like I did on the first card. I just like that added bit of shine, and it dries completely clear for a really cool look. And that finishes off card number two. I had so much fun making these finger paintings. I know there was that flower print that I didn't show you. If you would like to see me make a card with that, make sure you leave a comment below and let me know. I hope that you are maybe inspired to do something out of the box, maybe some finger painting. And I will be back again very soon with another video. So make sure if you're new here, you subscribe and you can ring the bell, and YouTube will let you know when I post that next video. All right, I'll see you again very soon. Happy stamping. Bye.